let's first welcoming Mr. Nichol Bob, the co-founder and CEO of Getlinks, to the stage.
Hey, my name is John Farr, I'm the co-founder and CEO of Getlinks. Getlinks, we are the first Thai startup to go to Silicon Valley and receive funds from California. We have been operating for 3 years, and what we're doing is basically connecting a tech talent network. So we are building this ecosystem of Silicon Valley across South Asia. We operate in 6 markets today, so Thailand, of course, Vietnam, Singapore, Hong Kong, South Korea, India. And we have been helping companies like Alibaba, Google, Facebook to build their offices across the region. And how do we do that is obviously by connecting talents, but I will be talking about that also to help talents to discover that the tech is a sexy place to work, and all these startups are actually very impactful if you join them. So that's what we've been doing with Getlinks during the last 3 years, and definitely this education topic is an incredibly important topic for us, because it's about creating this pool of talent that can be the future of this country. And yes, Thailand needs it, and that's very exciting for us to be here today. Thank you. Anyways, but about education, that's something that I think everyone is pissed off, right? I don't want to share another bad experience, but I saw that maybe I ask a question here. We have like maybe 40 people. So how many of you guys have really felt like the last book you read at school have been useful for your first job? Please raise your hand. Okay, among you guys, who think that the things that you have read at school from your last book that you have read at school haven't been useful? Please raise your hand. Okay, so this is something that seriously hurts me as well. Like, I've been doing my MBA, and honestly, what I've got from my MBA is not really the skills. It's not really, you know, the education. Even if I was paying this very expensive MBA for education, and my parents were telling me, hey, you better get a good job after this MBA because it's really expensive. So one thing along the way is, I really feel looking back, stepping back, is I've learned most of the skills by myself. And that's something that is actually pretty funny, because you're paying very expensive education, and at the end, what you can actually use at the workplace is the skills that maybe you've learned on a video or maybe talking to a friend. So I think one that is, I don't really like recruitment. I don't really like education, because I think it sucks. And I think the enablers of the education up to today are not the ones that have made me and my friends successful yet. And this is why I think there's an incredible opportunity to challenge that, to challenge those enablers, those job platforms, those education platforms. And that's what you guys are doing, and that's why I'm very amazed. So I'm not gonna share you an experience, but more like a question to yourself. Are you happy with the existing education system? Maybe not. That's why you come to watch this event today. And maybe in the next couple of minutes, we're gonna have some question about, okay, well, how can we solve it, and what you guys doing to solve that. I think it's pretty cool. So yeah, thanks.
All right.
Okay, so for our side, we help people to get a job, right, in technology company. So we need to find talents, and then we need to find companies that want to hire those talents. And so looking at the data, on Thailand, I think we've seen last year 570,000 students who graduated. And on these 570,000, only 50,000 were actually employable. So that means that for most of those students that graduated, they were not having the skills relevant for the market. And whatever they could apply to JobsDB or Workcruncher or whatever, they will not get a job at the end because they are just not relevant. And that's something that we have seen for us at Getlinks, especially for the IT students. I think on the 13,000 engineers who graduated from the best universities in Thailand, only 2,000 of them actually got to a job last year. This is something that's pretty scary. And we have got those two data from DIPA, and that's something that we really hope that we can work together with these different organizations, because that's a common problem. So this is something that's happening in Thailand, but don't worry, it's happening in all of South Asia. And it's not only happening in all of South Asia, it's happening all around the world. And this is just because the nature of work itself has changed. During the past decades, we have seen new skills, technology emerging. You've seen Ruby on Rails developer. Who knew what is a Ruby on Rails developer 10 years ago? We have seen UX designer. Who knew what is a UX designer? It doesn't exist. So this is a global shift that's happening with those amazing technology, those mobile phones that we're having. The workplace and the skill set that are required to work at this workplace need to change as well. And that's something that we need to rethink the education. So it's not only for South Asia, it's not only for Thailand, it's something that's global. And I think that's where technology maybe can help, maybe online, maybe with decentralized classes, etc. But that's definitely something that needs to be fixed if we want to be able to solve this education and also solve these jobs, which relate more to me. So I think that's very interesting what you just said. In fact, 65% of the students who will graduate in the next few years will work on jobs that doesn't exist today. 65%. That's some global data from the World Bank. So how do you get to know what to learn? And how do you create this solution where actually you can get up to the speed? And it takes a lot of time to update the scores. So maybe there's a third way. Maybe you need to rethink how do you learn. Maybe it's not at school. Maybe it's on the BTS. Maybe it's on your computer after work. Maybe it's in this coffee. Maybe it's talking to your friends right there. Maybe it's going to a meetup and meet people who are passionate about this new skill, which is called Photoshop. And this is what Yelkins are trying to explore now. How do we bridge this gap by not sending people at school, not sending people to learn online or learn a book, but meeting peer-to-peers, meeting people who are passionate about, for example, UX design, meet them around a beer, meet them around a meetup, meet them around a community of people that have been adapting their skill sets to the skill set that are relevant today. And I get thanks for exploring this path today of creating this community of adapted workers that know the latest skills, but also can share to the people who don't know to just by meeting them. We see that, for example, for a skill like Docker. Is there any developer here in the room? Raise your hand. Okay, so one guy. So Docker is this very extremely high-paid skill. I tell you, if you want to be rich tomorrow, learn Docker. We have jobs and things that are paid like almost $1 million a month. But the thing is, there's no one who knows Docker in Thailand. But most of our clients, they're looking for Docker developer, right? $1 million a month, can you believe that? So you don't learn this skill set online. There is no school who can provide you that. The only way to learn Docker is to talk to another Docker developer. And that's where maybe you can meet around the meetup. And that's something that we're exploring. So for us, it's how can you learn by doing, and not by sitting on a chair in a boring school with a teacher that you don't like, but how can you learn by doing internship? How can you learn by doing jobs for different companies and learn in the workspace? Because we believe that that's for us definitely the shortest way to create this new skill set and to help those people to get the job. Now, there's many other ways to do it. You talk about MOOC, there's incredible stuff from different platforms. I think you guys are doing an incredible job as well. We want to do stuff with you, by the way. But aside of that, yeah, for us, Getlinks is really how do we create this community of people that can meet and share the insight, share the new skill set, and grow together. That's what we do. I think this one. I think learning from both of you guys thinking, right, it's very interesting because we realize that actually the biggest problem of the education is not that the resources aren't there. They're online, or they are from your peers. So the key is really, I'm bored. It's 8 p.m. I just finished work. Why do you want me to learn anything? Or even at school, like, I don't care about this thing. Why do you want me to learn? I don't want to learn. I got my job from my parents. Worst case, I can work with my father, right? Or maybe I have my farm, maybe, you know, whatever. So why should I learn? That's the question, right? I think this is really about inspiration. And I think something that true digital power can do, and this is also why all this startup Silicon Valley thing can do and can be exciting, is inspire people to use their skills to contribute to the world by disrupting industry or by just solving some people's problem, by building a startup, by working a startup. It's about passion. And I think if we had this passion, then of course I want to find a skill so I can contribute to something, and I can find my place in the world. So I think the biggest problem with education is actually the passion. Because right now, yeah, I can learn anything online, but why do you want me to learn anything online? I don't have anything to work on, because it's not interesting. So I think Digital Park creates this new opportunity of inspiring all those young people about building their own startup, joining a startup, contributing to build Thailand 4.0, contributing to the future of this country. And it's like patriotical. You don't learn to learn. It's boring. You don't go to school to go to school. You go to school because you want to have a skill so you can help your country to become the best country in the world. And that's, I think, maybe that's something that you guys can contribute with True Digital Park. Inspiring those new generation to get a skill, to educate themselves, to then help those ecosystems of startup and technology company to help Thailand to move forward.
Thank you.
So, yeah, I think tonight we realized two things. First is education is broken, but we knew it already a little bit. Two is education will need to merge with other industry to be really bring back the passion, right? So for GetLinks, we see that because every day we see people applying to jobs, we contact them for jobs, etc. We tell them, hey, sorry, you're a marketer, but you need to become a digital marketer. And they're like, oh, what is digital marketing? And then this is where we need to do the next milestone, which is tell them, hey, okay, you can go to this website and learn digital marketing and come back to GetLinks in 3 months. So during last year, we actually have done a lot of that. So much that we have hired 20 talent coaches who are spending their day to advise talents on their career path and what's the digital skill they can learn and what's the next language they can learn, what's the next skill they can learn. So maybe we're not going to acquire a company. Let's see. At least we can do partnership together with education platforms. But something is true is GetLinks will move towards education. This year, that's one of the big motto of this year, is developing this what we call adaptive work community of people who can learn via peer-to-peer, like meeting around events that we organize and that our friends organize, maybe Globish organizes as well. And then, on the second step, connect them to the opportunities that we have across Asia on our platform. Because we believe that for tech talents particularly, for those digital marketers, developer, designer, there's no barrier. If you can speak English and if you can do Photoshop, you can literally work anywhere. You can work in Thailand, you can work in Vietnam, in Hong Kong, in France, in the US, from the beach, anywhere. And this is those kind of opportunities that we want to provide to those people who learn English and know Photoshop, for example. So GetLinks this year will be creating this platform that helps those people to reach what we call the freedom of work, where they can not only work on the skills that they like with the company that they like, but also anywhere they want across the 6 offices that we have in Asia. So that's our big goal for this year, and the community is going to be an extremely important part. We are aiming to partner with extremely big events like Startup Thailand, Digital Big Bang, etc. to drive this community of talents that have been adapted to the work requirement of today. And we hope to work with True Digital Park a lot. We're expecting events from 2,000 to 5,000 people in the next coming month, online and offline, so that's a very exciting thing for us. And again, we want to include everyone that is interested about solving this mission. So it's not only GetLinks. We will work with Work Venture at some point. We will work with all the actors here because we believe the problem is so big that solving this problem is actually changing lives. So this is not about the competition. It's about how do we help those guys to get a job, right? And how do we help them to actually have a living while doing something that they love, right? So that's big of a market to solve.
So quantum computing, okay? Commercialized last year. Microsoft just opened up the quantum computing open source code. This is this is literally 360 degrees from any code that's in the marketplace now. It's how do you guys look at the gap with the rate of technology that's coming? And, you know, if you talk about gaps now, we've got gaps that are being created by the technology that everything will be obsolete within 5 years, simply because of the capabilities that quantum computing is going to potentially provide, if there's people. So how does that get close? How do you deal with that? How do you frame that problem from all the things you've talked about? Where's the niche opportunity for education? Is Microsoft going to own it? I mean, you with me?
Anyone want to take this one, or I take it?
Okay,
cool. So that's the hard question, right? We always have this question, like, oh, how do AI gonna, you know, transform the world? And yeah. So just some data. Thailand is on the World Bank report, the same one I will share to you guys. I'm 72% of risk of automation for the whole workforce. That means that on the 35 million people working in Thailand, maybe 72% of them are going to be actually replaced by machines and automation in the next 10 years. So yeah, that's scary. As much as this computer, quantum computer. So this is where there's two ways to learn a skill. Either because you are passionate about this skill and you want to contribute, or either because you are scared to lose your job and to not have money to feed yourself. So we've talked about the first one at the beginning. But yeah, that's the reality. Actually, for the people who will not be able to adapt quickly, they're gonna lose their job. And technology like quantum computing is gonna actually accelerate this process of reducing the workforce needed. And imagine market like Thailand gonna be the first to be hit because there is such a gap that it's not even possible to learn to have a PhD to manage those technology, right? So this is where, yeah, that's very scary. That's, I hope, would be encouraging if people knew that to learn faster and to get something that they are passionate about faster. And I think it really is, it's going to be on the ground where you really need to have the government to collaborate with this park, like Three Little Park, to inspire more people to actually get a job and knowing what they like to do. Because when those technologies are going to come, it's going to be really apocalypse. You talk about AI, you talk about quantum, that's going to be apocalyptic. And I think really, about the park, it shouldn't be even, maybe we're going to become a school. Actually, this is your mission. And if you don't do it, Thailand is going to be hit very hard by those technology. And think about those millions of workers in Chiang Mai, and that you need to help educate them about that there is this technology coming. And that's where I don't see only Three Little Park as a school, but more as a media to announce this and to tell to all the people who maybe have no idea what's going on about technology, that technology is coming, and they can join, and they better join. Because everything going to become technology something at the end, right? Technology finance, fintech, technology HR, technology whatever. So I really see that Three Little Park have a mission to become this media to tell those people, hey, this is coming, try to find a way to survive and thrive into this digital economy instead of being wiped out.
We will try skill test, right? So especially for developers, right? It should be something very simple, very easy to track, right? Do you know JavaScript? Yes or no? What we have seen is actually, yeah, the soft skills are extremely important. And again, as the war is the skills required actually accelerating and changing all the time. It doesn't really matter if you know JavaScript or not. It's more like, can you learn a language within a month? A new language, because maybe JavaScript is obsolete next year. So one of the things we have, of course, we have skill tests on get things, this is required, etc. But at the end of the day, when you have a guy in front of you and you have all the skills, the best badges on get things, you know, JavaScript, 5-star, etc. It's more about, can you communicate with this guy? Can you do a high-five to him? So it's a lot about the soft skills. It's, at the end of the day, we realize that it's not really about what the skills you have, but how does the market perceive you with this? Think about it. It's not really about have you done this PhD or MBA. It's how does the market and how does the employer perceive you the day we are in front of it? And in this part, we realized recently that the review of the interview were more interesting and valuable than the skill test. So for getting to know, we are formalizing the review after the candidate go to the interview. Just like Uber, when you take Uber, you take the review of the Uber. You're writing 1 star or 5 star. Because it's not really how the driver is driving. It's not really, oh, is he driving fast? Did he do something bad? Driving is actually the whole experience by being with this driver. So this is why I believe skill tests are extremely important. And maybe AI will be able to help on this path. Definitely sure of that. But it's all about people at the end of the day. Because you work with them. So review, peer-to-peer review is something that I believe is very important. And that's something that is across any industry. It doesn't matter if it's tech or finance or maybe even lawyers. It's about peer-to-peer review because at the end it's about trust. How does the market trust this person to give you advice on this topic? Right. That's my point.